Moses talks about taking the children here in this particular passage to a particular route. And the Lord begins to tell Moses, I want you to go a different route because Pharaoh is going to think that you're entangled and I'm going to harden his heart. He and his army are going to begin to pursue after you. Look at what happens here. He sends him on a particular route and lets him know that the enemy is coming after you. Now, why in the world would God do that? Because he's God just like that. You don't know what he's going to do, how he's going to do it. Why in the world do you have me in this situation? Because I want to show you that I'm with you. I want you to see that I am with you. When it looks crazy to you, when you don't understand, he uses the foolish things to confound the wise, the things that make you look and say, my God, now why would you do that? Because I wanted to bring you out the way I wanted to do it, so nobody could get the credit, nobody could take the glory, nobody could get the pat on the back, so that I can tell you that if God hadn't done this, then it wouldn't have been done. Do I have a church in here? Come on, clap your hands and give him praise. He says, don't be afraid, but stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. For the Egyptians that you see today, you'll see them never again, no more. I want you to know that God is getting ready to abolish your enemies. He's getting ready to abolish your haters. Those who said you weren't going to make it, you weren't going to take it. He says, the enemy that you see today, just get ready, stand still, and look at my salvation, because you're never going to see them ever again. You're not going to struggle with the same stuff over and over. You're not going to keep crying over the same stuff over and over. You're not going to keep drying the same tears. You're not going to keep worrying over this. God said, the enemy that you see today, you're never going to see them. I'm going to annihilate them. I'm going to abolish him. I'm going to let them know that he has no authority over you. You got to know who you are. Come on, clap your hands and give him praise. And so here, the enemy is in hot pursuit, and the children are running, and they're running. They're going before them. They look and see the sea. Oh my God, what's going to happen? They look and see their enemies behind them. What's going to happen? Have you ever been in a situation where your back was against the wall, and you didn't know what God was going to do and how he was going to do it? And you say, Lord, I don't know what you're going to do. I don't know how you're going to do it. How you going to get me out of this? But he always provides a way of escape. He always lifts you up and takes you out. Oh, clap your hands and give him a praise. I feel God in the house. I'm feeling healed. And the Bible says that the Lord caused the sea to go back by a strong east wind. Now, let me talk about the east wind. When the east wind blows, the east wind is strong. The east wind is forceful. The east wind originated in the east, and then it blows toward the west. It is otherwise known as a trade wind. Trade winds are east winds. They're winds that blow consistently. They blow violently. They blow vehemently. They blow in a prevailing pattern. When the east wind blows, it blows in a particular pattern that everything that's in its way, it will annihilate. It can bring things with it, and it will clear paths. Do I have a church that knows where I'm going? Oh, yes. The east wind blows. It originates in the east, where the sun rises and lightning is formed. Matthew 24:27 says, for as the lightning came out of the east and the sun and shines even in the west, so shall the coming of the sun be. The east winds, oh, it comes, and some say that the east winds are scorching winds. They blow so until they tear through everything that is in its path, but they blow in a steering direction to clear a pathway. The east wind blows to make a path and to make a track. The east wind can cause both destruction and it can cause deliverance. For the children of Israel, God sends an east wind to create a path of victory. And sends an east wind to clear the way so that they can go forth. For me, direction. Oh, you got to know that when the east wind blows in your life, if you're a child of the King, if you're living for God, if God's got his hand on your life, you won't be able to walk through. He's going to blow on your situation. He's going to blow in your household. He's going to blow on your finances. He's going to blow in your spirit realm. He's going to blow the anointing in your life. And when the east wind blows, he wants you to know, I got you covered. Just follow the path that I've created for you. Oh, clap your hands and give him a praise in the house. Come on, somebody. Ah, yes. I want you to know that the enemy has plans, but God has greater plans. And I come to share with you that God is getting ready to send a strong east wind your way. You've been going through so much. You've been crying so long. You've been weary. You didn't know what to do. You've been going through the motions. You've been trying to make ends meet. You can't seem to get it all together. But God said, I'm getting ready to blow on your situation. I'm getting ready to send a strong east wind. And when the east wind blows, you're going to know I'm with you. I heard the Bible say, lo, I am with you always, even to the ends of the earth. I'm getting ready to blow out depression. I'm getting ready to blow out loneliness. I'm getting ready to blow out destruction. I'm getting ready to blow out weariness. I'm getting ready to blow out the spirit of I can't. I'm getting ready to blow into you another level, another dimension.
So you can get everything he's got for you. Come on, clap your hands.